First World Order Radio. Finally, we are on the air. No doubt. All right.
There's always going to be somebody in the building on First World Order Radio.
We get on into some of that order consciousness tonight.
First World Order Radio every Wednesday, 8 p.m.
We got to talk about what is taking place on the planet.
There's always going to be somebody in the building on First World Order Radio. First, we need to let you know we're going to be doing more shows, giving out more information on Wednesdays. Wednesday at 8 o'clock, we are now going to make this is the hottest day of the week.
Proceeding others in time, order, importance. The most prominent parts, voices, or instruments. Earthly state of human concerns in existence. An indefinite multitude, quantity, or distance. System regulates to bring about specifics in the group based on value and natural characteristics. Current radiates electromagnetistics of sound through the air, same as your thoughts transmits it. Proceeding others in time, order, importance. The most prominent parts, voices, or instruments. Earthly state of human concerns in existence. An indefinite multitude, quantity, or distance. System regulates to bring about specifics in the group based on value and natural characteristics. Current radiates electromagnetistics of sound through the air, same as your thoughts transmits it.
You need to understand how magical this, something like this every Wednesday can become. So you need to start getting your calendar right, get your schedule right. You need to know our intention straight out.
All right, so, I mean, these clues are given throughout the various languages was to piece the puzzle of this ancient mystery school back together again.
And what we plan on doing, both of us, is bringing y'all some surefire dynamite. We're going to take this level up a notch. We're going to have stuff to do here. This is not just going to be about philosophies and theories. Shit that works.
Peace. Welcome once again to Alim El-Bey's show. What we're going to try to do tonight is go into real hip-hop versus shit-hop, of course, called rap. In other words, you already heard the 20 songs played over and over again daily on your radio station. So we're not going to play those. What we're going to do is play some current underground hip-hop that I'm pretty sure you will like, that you might not be too familiar with. But before we can get into that, we want to give the show is dedicated to Brother Troy Davis, a brother who's basically no evidence for anything in which that they claim he have done, but yet they still plan on going to execute him. So we definitely want to give some shout out to that. We understand this is the same thing in which that was being done with OJ, and being that, I guess you can say Facebook is CIA ran, they want to gauge and see how upset the Negro population would be. And I don't mean Negro in the sense of just, in that connotation, but I'm talking about black people, i.e. Moors, whatever the case is. They want to see how upset we can get or be to see if it can create a race war, civil war in this country, and which that would bring the final collapse to the economic or the economy, because remember, this is what they plan on doing. They plan on collapsing the economy, but they need a trigger in order to blame it on. And as usual, they always want to blame it on the Negroes. So this is the thing in which they're moving towards. This is one of the events in which that they would like to see start that. All right? This is their bigger plan or their bigger agenda. We're looking at Troy Davis as, of course, as an individual, and, of course, as the fact that the man is innocent and the fact that they're still going forth. And Uncle Tom, Clarence Thomas, United States Supreme Court, they stated to go and continue on with this murder, you know, of this innocent man, even though there's new evidence to show that he's innocent. So these are the things in which that we have to be aware of. This is all part of the same white supremacy agenda that we started these programs out on, in which that Nellie Fuller and Francis Quince Wilson, both doctors, PhDs within their particular field of psychology, psychiatry, in which that promotes the understanding, the overstanding, the understanding that the white man, white woman fear genetic annihilation. And how is they genetically annihilated is through the black penis and the black vagina. And that's how they are genetically annihilated. So the most deadliest thing to them is the genitalia. Hence the reason why for the lynching, when they did lynch the black male, they were cut off the genitalia because of that fear. Or the woman, they would if they lynched the black woman, they would cut off the breasts. Even with Sarah Barton, the story of Sarah Barton in the 1800s is that they were so amazed with her behind, you know, she was called a Hottentot, or she was from the Bushmen tribe from out of South Africa. She actually was from the same tribe as Nelson Mandela. And the thing is that the Brussels in England came from them being so amazed about her behind, being that it was so large or so big. Now, they even cut off, after she died, they stuffed her body and they actually put her behind on exhibit. And Nelson Mandela in 1992 had to go and get her body part in order to give her a proper burial. So this is the mentality of these individuals, so-called said elite, Illuminati, or whatever term that we want to refer to as, in which that they have their tentacles spread throughout all of the various systems or facets of society, i.e. entertainment. So we just want to go into that. And once again, let's go into this Baphomet oath in which that everyone is talking about. Now let's go into the actual origin of Baphomet and where that came from. Where Baphomet is actually Muhammad, in which that when the Knight Templars got excommunicated by the Catholic Church, they corrupted the name Muhammad to Baphomet. All right? Now, originally, that name came from Muhappimat. Muhappimat. A Muhappimat is actually the River Nile God. All right? If you go and check your Gerald Massey lectures, Ancient Egypt, The Light of the World, The Book of Beginnings, The Natural Genesis by Gerald Massey, he gets into how happy is the Nile River God. Mu is water. Happy is the deity or Netter. All right, that force, that power of the water itself, that spirit. And Mat actually is truth, justice, righteousness, reciprocity, balance, order, peace. So those seven principles are symbolic to Ma'at. So actually, they say that Muhammad brought Serim. Serim means the sanctuary of peace, or the sanctuary of peace of Ra. So hence, the origin of the peace of Ra, or the peace of Ra, becomes Allah. So hence, they say that Muhammad brought Allah, or Islam, to the people. This is where that origin of that story comes from. You got to go back and check the ancient Kemetic Metuneta words for these particular deities. Whenever you see like Raham, those are ancient Kemetic terms. When you see Emmanuel, ancient Kemetic terms again. When you see Muhammad, ancient Kemetic terms again. A lot of the Hebrew and Arabic, being that they are 65% of the Metuneta, is derived exactly from the language spoke by the ancient Egyptians or the Temerians or Egyptians or Kemetans, as they would say, or the Kamals. All right, so we have to understand this, you know. So this is where the Baphomet you know, energy actually derives from. It's from Happy the Now God. So, you know, this is the oath that they claim that they're taking now in Hollywood, in which that's being perverted, you know, by those who supposedly practice the occult, in which that Eliphaz Levi back in the 1800s supposedly drew the picture of Baphomet, in which that we now see, in which that the Satanists use to this very day, in which that shows an inverted five-pointed star goat head, or the goat with the left hand down and the right hand up, signifying the yin and yang, or the yin and yang, which symbolizes the bringing forth of the balance. And then you see the raising of the kundalini, it leads up to the navel chakra, which symbolizes the life component or the abode in which that the kundalini dwells in, the sacral bone area. All of this is shown within that picture. Now, if you want to go and find out what Eliphaz Levi actually meant by the drawing of the Baphomet from the 1800s, then you have to read his own words, and that will help bring clarity to this matter. So whatever Hollywood is practicing, or the entertainment field is practicing, or the industry with these various artists, whether it's sports entertainers, whether it's actors, actresses, whether it's musicians, whatever the case is an oath that's based fraudulently on nothing more than the selling of your soul, as they would say. Your soul actually is, you can't sell your soul. Your melanin is the physical counterpart of your spiritual soul. What you're selling is your integrity, your honesty, your pride, and that's what you're selling out. That's what that actually symbolizes. All right? So even when you do a contract, the only thing that simply means is that you're allowing through the contract these entities to come and speak to you, channel through you, those various gifts called the music or the muse. That's what that is all symbolic to. And if you don't know how to handle those channels from those entities, because most of them is lower entities of the first and second overtone of the astral plane, this is actually what you are dealing with, you know, with these entities. You're not dealing with the fifth dimensional, 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th, 10th, 11th, 12th, or 13th dimensional beings or entities. You're dealing with the lowest of the low, just an octave higher than this third-dimensional plane. And David Icke referred to them as the reptilians, all right? You know, we'll just say that they are some type of alien force, all right? I won't say necessarily just reptilian, but that's have been used, in which that attached themselves to the first and second chakra, which the word chakra means seats of light, color, and sound, in which that there are conscious centers, melanin centers, actually, within those who are melanated, or the Moors, you know, male and female. So these are melanin centers, so, and they are conscious centers. So that means your mind, if it's strong enough, can detach those entities at any given time, you know. However, most people become pawns to these entities because they go after the fame and fortune, the lust, the greed, the envy, the hatred. And so this is the realm in which that they dwell on, which is the materialistic realm. And this is what they end up getting. They get those things, but in the same instance, they have no love. Let's look at Michael Jackson. You know, he was worth, he had the Beatles collection, he had the Elvis collection, which was actually an estimate of actually $4 billion. You know, but they kept referring to him as being broke. But that was his assets, you know. But look at what Michael Jackson did to himself in that regard. You know, he hated his nose, he hated his skin color, and he wanted to get the farthest away from having the facial features of his father, Joseph, in which that he was actually Michael Joseph Jackson. You know, okay, he had his father's name. So he was trying his best to get away from looking like his father. And so that was a form of self-hatred, as well as also that was based on the abuse in which that he received as a young child from his father, you know, physical abuse, in which that, you know, we don't know what psychological effects outside of the outward appearance change in which that we have seen, the mental problems in which that took place, you know, with the allegations of him supposedly molesting the children, you know, on two different occasions. Of course, we know that most of that was just nothing more than extortion in which that they gained, I believe it was like, you know, $20 million or more, you know, from those particular cases, you know, particularly the first case in which that was able to go away based on the fact of Michael having to pay them that amount of money. So, you know, we have to look at, you know, the things in which that's going on. I mean, let's look at Lil' Kim. She's done the exact same thing in which that Michael Jackson has done. So that means she has gone through a phase of self-hatred herself. And that it really hit home because that is hip-hop. You know, here go, you know, gangster mama, you know, as we would say, you know, always talking about, you know, being gangster, you know, a gangster slash, sex goddess or whatever the case is. And, you know, now she done, you know, did her face, you know, her boobs, whatever else, and lighten her skin. You know, so now she's like the female version of Michael Jackson. So this is what we are seeing now within the hip-hop, as well as within reggae, is the lightening of the skin. They're going back to that nonsense again, you know. So these are the things in which that is taking place, and we just have to be aware. And so this is why we propagate conscious music. Big shout-out to the 5% Nation of Gods and Earths. That's my foundation. Been my foundation since I was 14. So no doubt, a lot of the music in which that is conscious have come out from the school of the school of Mecca, from out of the Nation of Gods and Earth, from the 5%ers. I mean, and we look at Rakim. You know, he came from that school. You know, KRS-One just did a song with Grand Poopa, and they both talked about the 5%. They both came from that school. You know, so the music in which that was going on in the late 80s and early 90s, you know, in which that branched off from Melly Mel's The Message, you know, because that's really, you know, how cats came conscious within the hip hop was from The Message. Everyone had basically said that or stated that, you know, is that when they heard The Message, you know, that's when they started saying, look, we got to put something within our lyrics in which that makes sense, in which that, you know, instead of just, you know, the dang, da dang, da dang, da dang, dang, you know, instead of just, you know, that type of stuff, you know, they had to move away from that, you know, they had to move from that, and they had to become more conscious of what they were saying, because they understood that there had to be a message in the music, all right? So that's what's going on. We have to take it back to that. You know, recently, Lil Wayne made a statement, you know, in which that I heard other rappers make a statement about, you know, not caring any longer about what they're saying. And that's obvious, you know, from the music content. You know, they have gone as far as they can consciously, you know, on their realm where they are at. You know, so, you know, we expect for them to, you know, bring something conscious out in which that will help wake up the masses. No, they done sold out. They sold themselves, you know, their integrity, their honesty, their pride, you know, for fortune and fame. That's the exchange. And the exchange, like we said earlier, was to be able to channel these certain beings, spirits from the fourth dimension, whom attached themselves at the first and second chakra level, in which that some artists, you know, musicians, you know, all perfectly possessed, meaning that they look just like normal people to us. You know, they speak very well. You know, they're eloquent. You know, they've gone to school. They have degrees or whatever the case is. However, they're demonic in the sense that they're being controlled like a puppet on strings by the spirit world on behalf of the industry. You know, and that's the bondage that they took when they took that, you know, said Bachman oath. Like we said, Bachman is not, you know, the actual word in which that, you know, we can be using or should be using. But that is the word in which that has been propagated based on the conspiracy tapes and based on, you know, the information that has come forth, in which that does require, in a sense, for those type of beings, you know, on the fourth dimension, blood sacrifice, you know. Or dehumanize yourself, which means making a sacrifice that you have to do. Like, for example, this, you know, these rappers going a year, going to jail for 1 year and 1 day type of thing. That's a self-sacrifice. You know, that's for them being able to have the fortune of fame or to continue having the fortune of fame or to have, you know, to pay back for them having the fortune of fame. You know, that's one way. Or, you know, or killing a family member is another way of a blood sacrifice, in which that some artists have actually stooped down so low in order to do. You know, so I mean, these are the things in which that is going on in Hollywood, as we would say, and throughout the globe. You know, I mean, let's just look at it. There's still no reports of the 2,500 children in which that was missing or has been missing from Louisiana, from out of New Orleans during the Katrina disaster. No report. All right, I know the Final Court did an article within the first week or two of the Katrina disaster stating how there was 2,500 children that was missing. Well, no one is found yet, you know, as far as where these children are located at. You know, but we speculate that they are in sex rings worldwide, because there's a black market for that, as well as also human sacrificed, you know, during rituals, you know, in order for individuals can gain some type of power over this earthly realm. And being that you're dealing with blood, blood is life, you know, and so hence they feel by killing an animal or a human being, you can gain access, because the energy in which that is released, you can actually utilize that energy and trap it and conjure it up, you know, through a spell or spellbind, in which that you'll say certain words over the captured energy so that that energy or that spirit can do certain things for you on your behalf. This is the things in which that they believe, and it is a knowledge is so, because when you go into the African religion, such as the Yoruba, the Akan, which is the Ifa, the Palo Mayombe, the Congo, right, or any of the African religions, a sacrifice is required, such as within the Old Testament by the Hebrews, Israelites, or Jews. There was a animal sacrifice in which that was required. And then, of course, you even read in there, there was sometimes of human sacrifices in which that took place. Even Abraham put his son, Isaac, on the altar to be sacrificed to God. You know, so all of these things is long traditions, hundreds and thousands of years. You know, so this is nothing new. But the thing is that it's been kept under wraps by the industry, you know, from people, you know, who are so trapped in the, I guess you can say, they're so Christianized, they can't see nothing but white Jesus, and they can't see what's really going on around them. And plus the fact that they still waiting for white Jesus to come out the sky in order to save them, you know. So since we have individuals, which is the masses of the people in the United States, is relegated down to that level of thought, you know, that part of consciousness, of which I don't really know what part that is. But since they believe it, you know, then it is so. Your thoughts produce thought forms, all right? And that's what has been produced, a white image of this Jesus character, as fictitious as it is, as allegorical as it is, and as much as it is based on the character of Heru, and Heru symbolizes the light, and the light in which that is referring to is actually your auric field, and actually your kundalini, and the activation of the pineal gland from the merger of the bride and bridegroom, or Osorn or Set, from their divine marriage in heaven, in which that produced through that sexual union, or through the merger of the kundalini and the pineal gland, the activation of the soul, the awakening of the soul, the resurrection of the soul, which is Heru, which is the light, which is that gold disc around the top of your head, in which that is emitted once you have reached the seventh level, or you have broken the seventh seal. Hence the reason why they say that Muhammad was the last seal of the prophets, is because they're talking about the seven seals in your body, the seven Elohim, the seven archangels. That is nothing more than your seven chakras. And he being the last seal of the prophet symbolizes the cracking or the breaking of that last seal, which is the crown chakra. So you have Adam as the root chakra, Noah as the navel chakra, Abraham as the solar plexus, David as the heart, Moses as the throat chakra, Jesus as the third eye, and Muhammad as the seventh chakra. So hence the last seal of the prophets. Those are the seven prophets, which symbolizes the seven chakra system, the seven churches. Everything in which that is mentioned in the book of Revelation, as far as the number seven, going into the number 12, we're talking about your chakra system, and then your new heaven and new earth when it becomes a 12 chakra system. This is what this is metaphysically actually talking about. So we need to demystify the religions by studying more metaphysics in order to gain a clearer understanding, overstanding, understanding of what actually is taking place with the symbolisms and the subliminal messages in which that we see around us and that we hear within the music. All right. So now you really know the signs behind Lucifer and what's really going on. It's your lowest chakra. All right. That is your Kundalini, the serpentine fire that must be risen up. If I took a six-pointed star configuration called tetrahedron and placed it over your physical body at 19 degrees, I would see an upswelling of energy. All right? If I did it at 19 degrees north, I would see an upswelling of energy. So that means that the upswelling of energy must connect to, from 19 degrees south, must connect to the 19 degrees north in order to produce another upswelling of energy. All right? In which that upswelling of energy is Heru, or Christ. All right, in which that you refer to as Jesus. But actually, when you break down the name Jesus, the word Jesus comes from the word Shu, Yahshua. It's his Aramaic or Old Hebrew name, or Yahshua. Now, when you break down Shu, Shu is the ancient Kemetic name or the mental netter for the firstborn begotten son of Atum. Hence the reason why they say Jesus is the second Adam, because Shu is the second Adam, beget the firstborn, just like Jesus said to be the first begotten son. All right? So this is the correlation. So Shu, within the ancient Kemetic text, is the air personified, the personification of air. In other words, the breath of life. Hence the reason why Christians say that Jesus was with God in the beginning. The reason why, because God blew Jesus into you. Hence the reason why it says that God blew into the nostrils of man and made man a living soul. All right, this is why you sneeze and you say, Yahshua, Yahshua. It's because you actually are calling on a deity called Jesus or his Aramaic name or Old Hebrew name, Yahshua. It's talking about the breath of life. That's what it's referring to. That's what it's talking about. So let's get away from all this spookiness. It ain't no white man coming out no sky to save you. You must save yourself through the science of the breath of life because the word Yahshua or Yahushua means, oh, he who saved. Means salvation. So that means that the breath of life is your salvation. That's what merges your lower self and your higher self to become one self, to become Allah, to become Ura, to become Atum, to become Ptah, to become Amin. That oneness must come through the merger of the Shu, the Yahshua, Yahweh, a Yahwah. Shu is in between Yah and the way. Yah symbolizes the higher self. Way symbolizes the lower self. So hence, Shu symbolizes the medium, just like Shu was the medium between Geb and Nut. Nut symbolizes the higher self. Geb symbolized the lower self. On the ancient Kemetic metanetal hieroglyphics, whenever you look at that, you see Shu in an upright position with his hands in a cow position, which means spirit, and he was the stabilizer between heaven and earth. This is what is meant in the Old Testament when it speaks about the firmaments of the separation of the firmaments of the air and of the ocean and waters or the and the land. It was a separation. The separation was that of Shu, who separates. All right? That's what that is talking about. But Shu also brings back into balance. All right? So these are the things that we have to understand, overstand, understand. The metaphysics, the ancient Kemetic teachings. If you don't understand the mental nature, if you do not understand what the ancient Egyptians was trying to convey or the Tamarians was trying to convey, then you're missing the whole point. If you're taking the Bible, the Quran, or any of these books, the Holy Kabbalah, the Hispanicide, the Maharabah, the Lost Books of the Bible, Forgotten Books of Eden, the Apocrypha, any of these books, if you're not taking it back to ancient Egypt, then you have lost the point. Because that's where we can go right now and see, still on the walls, on the temples, on the pyramids, we can still see what the ancestor was trying to convey to us. All right? So we know in the Temple of Het-Heru, they have the Immaculate Conception scene, which is the same thing mentioned within the book of Luke. All right? Where it speaks about the angel Gabriel, who's actually Tahuti, coming to Mary, who's actually all set to tell her that she's going to have a son or a child who is Heru, which is Jesus. The same scene is right there. So we have to understand the actual transliteration. And so when you're talking about Lucifer, when you're talking about Uriel, you're actually talking about Heru. This is why when you read the Satanic Bible, you see the name Horus, Amen, all of them as names for the devil, or for Lucifer. This is the reason why it must be resurrected. This is what this is all talking about. But see, we are so spooky, you know, we have to demystify this stuff so that, you know, when we understand these things, overstand these things, understand these things to its fullest point, we're not scary. You know, we don't scare death. You know, we're not scared of death. We're not scared of, we're not scared to live. Because that's actually what's going on. From what I see, a lot of people are scared to live. And they claim that they're ready to die, but they don't know what's after this. You know, it's just like what Tupac said, you know, niggas talking about they want to die, but, you know, they want to go to heaven, but ain't ready to die. You know, well, you ain't ready to die. Well, how about you ready to live? You know, there is a purpose in life. You know, why don't you live and master yourself to learn the science of teleportation, dematerialization. How to raise your vibratory rate without having to leave your physical body. Not necessarily having to astral travel or soul travel, but actually taking your physical body with you, called a macabre, which your body turns into a UFO or a flying chariot or a flaming chariot. All these things are possible. The ancients have spoken about this. It is within the Bible. It's within the Quran. It's within the Bhagavad Gita, the Hispanicized. It's within all these various texts. You know, we're the ones in which have gotten away from ourselves. And if you don't think this shit is possible, then we'll ask yourself why you only use 10% of your brain. And what the other 90% for? Why are scientists only able to see 10% spectrum of the universe? What the other 90% of the universe is made out of? It's said to be dark matter, partially black energy and black matter. 35% dark matter, 25% dark black energy, I think it's up to 65% totally of black matter. So it comes up to about 90%. Now the physical incarnation of that is your melanin. Melanin is the physical counterpart to the spiritual soul. So melanin is your dark matter. Your melanocytes act as black holes to capture light. As I said this before, 300,000 tons of stardust energy falls to the planet Earth daily. Scientists have already found out and discovered that your physical body is composed of stardust energy. You are a walking, living star. But you have lost the science of how to regenerate yourself and rejuvenate yourself and re-energize and revitalize yourself, which is in the practice of Qigong and Tai Chi and Reiki and Pranic Healing, Pranayama, Kundalini Yoga, Tantra Kriya Yoga. It is within these various sciences that you learn how to master yourself once again, to learn how to use that energy in which that created your physical body into existence, which are the seven Elohims, or the seven eyes of Allah, the seven archangels, from Michael down to Uriel, how to utilize those energy. All right, this is the science. We have the learning. So we just break it down. Lucifer in Latin, his Hebrew name Uriel, the ancient Kemetic name, Heru. Hence in Freemasonry, why it's said that they worship Lucifer is because Heru becomes Hiram Abyss, who is hit in his head by the three ruffians who must be resurrected at a 90-degree perpendicular level. So hence it's talking about the energy inside of your body, because when you are horizontal, you walk on all fours like an animal. Your thoughts is that of an animal. You're just an animated body with a spirit. So you're an animated spirit with a body. Okay? So what happens is that because you live in your four lower devils, lust, greed, jealousy, and envy, you exhibit these traits so much, and you're so physical, and so emotional, and so mental, and so materialistic with these thoughts. This is what resonates from you, is the energy from these lower chakras. So hence, you're trapped in your own hell. So hence, after you die, if you do not go into your immortal body, your spirit dissipates and goes back into the spiritual realm, or what's called the realm of spirit, all right, or the realm of form, as we would say, in which that is utilized, that spirit is utilized for those who are still here on earth, particularly by the pregnant woman, once the sperm breaks off to the equivalent size of the nucleus of the egg, the head of the sperm breaks off to the equivalent size of the nucleus of the egg to go through mitosis, in which that forms the blastopores, in which that forms the physical body into existence after the eighth division, all right? What happens is that by the woman inhaling and exhaling through the breath of life, through the yashu, through the shu, she forms the physical body and mold and shape the physical body into existence based on the elements in which that was released from a person who passed on from the realm of form. This is the real science of what is going on here on planet Earth. Now, for those who have been able to get into their higher mortals, immortal bodies, hence the reason why we just finished playing immortal techniques, symbolic to the fact of immortality, everlasting, forever. Those three higher bodies are symbolic to what survived death. Now, you don't even have to die. You would actually have physical immortality if you understood the real principles of how to activate your gene codes, all right, and also your chromosomes, as well as also your DNA, as well as also the mental powers in which that lays latent within your cellular structure. Each cell is a template of the whole you, all right? In other words, I can take one cell from you, one speck of blood, one strand of hair, one speck of skin, and clone a whole other you into existence. So that means that your physical body is a hologram, and this is hence why you need to get the book Holographic Universe by Michael Talbert, in which that he shows and demonstrates that the physical body is a hologram as well as the universe. That's hence is the matrix. But what do you need a hologram? What does a hologram survive off of? It is light. It is light that the hologram survives off of. So if you're not getting enough light, if you're not eating enough light, your cells are not getting the proper nutrients from the proper light spectrum, through the proper music, through the proper frequencies, through the proper waves and channels, through the proper speech, through the proper thoughts, then your physical body becomes weakened. And it creates some negative thought forms and negative music and negative sounds and negative frequencies. It produces leaks in your auric field, holes in your auric field, and which that cause a person to become ill, sick, with ailments, dis-ease in the body. All right? So, hence, Heru, Hiram Abyss, who was knocked in the head, and the resurrection or the ascension of Christ symbolized. This is why Jesus had to die, as they would say within the story, and then he had to go into the depths of hell for 3 days and three nights to do battle with the devil in order to get the keys over hell and over death, and then resurrect or to ascend to his Father, which art in heaven, to sit on the right-hand side. That is talking about the Kundalini energy going up through the seven chakras is activating the right hemisphere of the brain, in which that is where the other percentage of the 90% is activated from. You're using 10% of your brain, which is only 10% of the left hemisphere of the brain. The other 40% of the right hemisphere of the left hemisphere of the brain you're not using, and then the other 50% of the right hemisphere of the brain you're not using. So that 50 and 40 you're not using. You're only using 10% of the left hemisphere of your brain, because that's the way you was trained, that's the way you was taught, that's the way you was indoctrinated. The dogmas, your belief system, all of these things must change. All these things must change. You must reprogram your mind. You yourself must do this. You must not allow others to control your mind. Mind control tactics. You must not allow for them to do so. You can't keep affording to do so. All right? Let's finish going into breaking down this Masonic conspiracy connection to hip-hop. All right? Now, the information I'm telling you, a Scottish Rite and a York Rite Mason can't tell you. But I know, because I'm a metaphysician. I haven't taken the oath in order to hold any information back from you. So listen closely to what I'm getting ready to say, because I already broke down a lot of it already. But pay attention. So check this out. So Lucifer, Uriel, Heru, the Negroes are referred to as the Heru people. The reason why, because it's talking about you are the Nagas, the serpent people, the masters of the Kundalini serpentine fire, the Kundalini Shakti, the Kundalini Shiva. So you are referred to as the master. This is what is meant by St. Patrick ran the snakes from out of Ireland, or the adders from out of Ireland. The adders or the snakes are talking about black people who have mastered the power of the Kundalini energy. It's raising up through those seven chakras, nine chakras, 12 chakra system. And we are moving from a seven chakra system. Dr. York said we have nine now, based on the fact that there's two glands which has been added to our system, in which that we have, after 2012, we will have 12 glands, various glands, in which that correlate to the 12 chakra system. But the two glands in which that's being added, you can study his work. He's referred to as the Barrett-Therry gland, which is a gland that was once within the hippocampus area of the brain, which is now within the submental area up under the chin area. About an inch or so behind the chin is like a little, is like a ball. It's two little balls up under your chin area in the area in the center. That is your Barrett-Therry gland. Everyone do not have that gland. All right? Matter of fact, I suggest that you check the people around you. For those who have that gland, they are the sons and daughters of Ra. For those who do not have it, means that their DNA has not been activated to have it as of yet, possibly, or maybe not have it at all. But that gland helped tap you into your psychic abilities, your psych chemistry, your clairvoyance, clairaudience, clairgestance, clairsentience. Those five higher senses outside of touch, taste, smell, seeing, and hearing. Then you have another gland inside your mouth. You can get Dr. Deborah Blair's Man, Woman, and Child lecture on this information. And he speaks about this mound at the top of your mouth. Is actually called the epiphany gland, or the talu gland, according to India, in the Sanskrit traditions. Everyone do not have this gland, but that gland, this is a mound at the top, and in the center of this mound is a hole in which that leads up into the third ventricle cavity. And when the pituitary gland and the pineal gland produce friction, it produces this yellowish chemical called cussum, in which that is called honeydew, in which that leaks down from out of the third ventricle cavity into the mouth area, and you can actually swallow this sweet taste and actually can rejuvenate your cellular structure. This is like the component of DMT, as they would say, for a person who meditate or easy to forget that for a person who can do deep meditation, that DMT is produced during that time period also, especially for a person who is a lucid dreamer, who can have out-of-body experiences or soul travel or so forth and so on. DMT is produced during those particular time periods. So a person who can do these types of things, these are the Christ or the gods and goddesses in which that is walking upon planet Earth. All right? I know it was until the 1980s that the Europeans started saying that that they started dreaming in color. Before that, I was taught that they dreamed in black and white. And this is what was taught in school, in elementary school. In junior high school, they was taught that they dreamed in black and white. So we had beings who look human, but they are just mankind, who are still dreaming in black and white, like some Ozzie and Harriet shit from Off the Beaver, Leave the Beaver. And that shows a low-grade consciousness. So you got to check these glands, check a person's thoughts. Or do you dream in black and white, or do you dream in color? I need to know. Are you colorblind? What's going on with you? Let me see if you got these glands. That way you know if you have a being who can transform or not, who can change or reform. Because remember, Elijah Muhammad said that the thing about the devil is that they can't be reformed. Well, you want to make sure that they have these various glands. And as we go into 2012 with this galactic alignment, more glands are going to be produced, in which that from our DNA or genetic code, in which that will give us access to 12 chakra system. All right? So this is what is going on with the resurrection of Haim Abeth or Heru. All right? Who was hit in the head by the three ruffians and then laid in the north. Laid in the north symbolizes the pineal gland. Like we said, if you took a tetrahedron and overplaced it on the body, overlaid it on top of the physical body at 19 degrees north, there should be an upswelling of energy. However, the soul is embedded inside of the pineal gland. God is sleep. This is what is meant by those who read various works or philosophies talking about God is dead. That's what it's talking about. Hiram Abeth. Hiram Abeth is said to be dead because he was knocked in the head by the three ruffians. And hence, that was a key laid in the north and then in the head, knocked in the head. That is talking about how you have amnesia now in the story. You're unconscious of oneself. So when Heru resurrects, then you have consciousness once again. You are now able to stand at a 90-degree perpendicular level. You are now resurrected. You are now able to ascend. This is what this is all symbolic to, through these Masonic rituals and ceremonies in which that individuals don't know what they're actually doing. You know, if they are so caught up to Christianity, then they will have no concept that it's the same story being told in Christianity. So then you have these ex Luciferians and Satanists who comes out and all of a sudden become Christians. That's nonsense. That's nonsense. They know that only reason why they would become Christians is because they knew they had a greater control over the masses than they did where they were. But they never let go of that information, because that information is based on control and energy. And most of those who come from those schools of thoughts want to control individuals and beings. You know, this is why the elite have such a fascination with population control agenda. They want to kill off 4 billion people on the planet or more. I know when I was coming up, I read an article in the New Amsterdam where it says that they wanted to kill off 2.7 billion non-white people, preferably by famine, drugs, AIDS, which is disease, and war by 2000. Well, 2000 came, and we had minor computer glitches for the Y2K, and that was it. As far as killing off the people, We Bebe kids. You know, especially the ones who got Bay on the end of their names. You Bebe kids. So this is the reason why they can't kill us off. All right? We are oldest being on the planet. We are the most indigenous. We are the original beings. All right? Some want to say aboriginal. I say original. So we are the most indigenous and aboriginal beings on the planet. Nothing is going to get done or said until you say so. All right? In other words, the thoughts in which that you must have is you recontrolling the planet because you are the highest energy on the planet. Right now, the planet is being controlled by the lowest energy. Well, the seats of the corporations is 98% of white male ran here in America. They are dominating the oil industry by going into other smaller countries and dominating over them and setting up military bases. They're controlling the oil and gold and the diamonds and minerals in Africa. You know, they use all these things as a base. You know, just with the IMF, World Bank, their monetary system, their Federal Reserve Bank, this Wall Street, their foreign stock exchange. This is what all these things is based on. It's them regulating the control of the elements on the planet. If we would have followed Marcus Garvey, we wouldn't be in this predicament that we're in right now. Because when they thought that he was talking about taking everybody back to Africa, he wasn't talking about all people. Matter of fact, he said there's some Negroes on which they need to stay here because they would be just as lazy there in Africa as they are here. All right? But what he was saying was that if the oil is good for the Rockefellers and the Rothschilds and the Cognies and the Morgans, why can't we have our own black Rockefellers, you know what I'm saying, our own black Rothschilds, you know, who control the diamonds and the gold and the oil, you know, for the benefit of raising our nation? Hence nationalism. This is true nationalism. This is true Pan-Africanism for those who are, say, revolutionaries. You have to get an economic base first, a military army to protect what you have invested and your assets. This is just common sense. If you don't have those things, then you don't have a revolution. So these are the things that we have to realize, and by understanding it more and more, then we'll get it. Let's continue on with the discussion. So, we are the real Illuminati. We are the Nagas, the serpent people, the Heru people, the masters of the Kundalini energy. Killer Priest already told y'all, the Earth is already in space. In other words, why are you looking to go to heaven when Earth is already in space? If you want heaven, make it here. Only reason why you're scared to make it here is because you're scared to go against the oppressor. Because he taught you how to fear and how to eat the wrong foods. Now genetically modified organisms. Gene alterating frankenfood. So now you're latent with fear, scared to say something that's on your mind. We have to break away from that. We have to understand what's really going on. By him making you fear, you are stagnating your own spiritual progression. You're keeping the Kundalini in its lowest level, and it will never raise or rise based on your fear. This is the reason why he have done the fear and panic throughout the world. Why he did 9-1-1. And why he's done all these other things. Because he wants fear. He keep coming up with this terrorist. But the word terror is short for terror, which means earth. Matter of fact, earth used to be called Helen. H-E-L-E-D. Because it is from the word held. Now, you can be in hell or held down. In other words, you can be a person behind the bars or the one who works to lock the motherfucker up behind the bars. And on me, a snitch. I ain't talking about like that. I'm talking about as far as in the sense of a warden or a sense of a guard. Because it is said, if you get, matter of fact, the same lecture, Dr. Derrick Blair, Man, Woman, and Child, he speaks about the fact that the earth, when we incarnated here, that some of us were like wardens or prison guards over the lower beings in which that was here. But we became so materialistic and so physically dense that we took on the same attributes as those in which that we was once guarding. And we have forgotten who we were, and now we become the ones locked in prison. In the prison is talking about your mind. You have confined and locked yourself within the confines of not just your physical body, the soul being in the physical body, and not knowing how to raise your vibratory rate to escape earth velocity, to escape what's called lockdown cold transmission or lockdown cold light transmission. You don't know how to do that now. You have not been taught how to raise your vibratory rate, which only by raising your vibratory rate to 7.3, you can actually break the gravitational hold of the planet Earth. The Earth's gravitational hold is very weak compared to the vibratory rate that you can actually produce. I suggest that you begin to start studying Dravalo Melchizedek and also Dr. Malachi York, who is also Melchizedek. His particular book, Malachi York's particular book, would be The Science of Creation and the Science of Healing, particularly the Science of Healing. Dravalo Melchizedek studied his 18-24-28 breath technique on how to form the macabre and transform your physical body into a ship. All right, you have to go into your mortal bodies, which is your throat, your third eye, and your crown chakra. They don't go no higher than the heart chakra, the solar plexus and the heart chakra. But you yourself, you can go higher with those teachings. For them, everything is about getting to the heart chakra, being able to show some type of love. And this is needed for them, even though that is still an aspect of the four devils. All right, we're going to the lines. The number that's up is 614. You're on the line. You're on the air. What's your question?
Peace, God.
Peace, God.
Hey, Brother Morgan, how you feeling, family?
Odell, God, how you doing tonight?
I'm good, man. I just got to say this right off the top, man. This is bananas how this is working out, man, how divine order, divine power is in control, man, because you just played the Immortal Technique joint before this one called Modern Day Slavery, and we just finished our show topic for October, and one of our shows is talking about, you know what I'm saying, slavery of the 21st century in the prison system. And not only that, man, to take it even further, man, this week, my show this week is based off of music. We playing real authentic hip-hop because we're going to be doing a live show at Ohio State University because Rob Parsley, a Jack Lake preacher here in Columbus, is debating Brother Malik Zulu Shabazz, head of the New Black Panther Party. So we're going to be at the debate giving live updates and playing this raw hip-hop, which you've been playing the last 2 weeks, man. And all this stuff has been planned months in advance, brother. So it's just crazy how we are all on the right page and doing the right things at the right time, man. So I just wanted to say that, man. It's just amazing.
I appreciate that, God. You know, all right, for those that don't know, this is my man, Brother Morgan. Tell everybody about your radio blog, God. And hit them up and tell them what they need to do to get you.
Yeah, we on every Sunday, man, from 6 to 8. Come check us out. You know what I'm saying? The Insightful Hour with Brother Insight. We have Brother Alim, who's a regular contributor to the show. He drops in once or twice a month. You know what I mean? Sitter Duke of Tears, you know, Dr. Kaba, Walter Williams was on this past Sunday talking about his two books, The Historical Origins of Christianity and Islam. And the most important thing we got going on, I was just telling your queen earlier, man, we opening up a school. People talk. I heard you talking about revolution as well, about being revolutionary. And what we're about to do here in Columbus is revolutionary.
No doubt.
Revolutionary and always about taking out guns and trying to go fight, you know what I'm saying? Because at the end of the day, they got more guns than we do. Let's just be 100. So
revolutionized that mind.
Absolutely, and that's what we're doing, friend. We're taking this revolution to a different level, and with the help of the great brother Marcus Klein from Chicago, my hometown, at Freedom Home Academy, he's going to be lecturing here this Saturday, and he's helping us launch our own homeschool, which will be opening this spring of 2012. This is our launch. We're going to have a whole bunch of parents with their children coming out, letting them see how Marcus and his son get down, showing them the curriculum, and then basically getting their information and letting them know, look, this same type of education will be here in Columbus in about 3 or 4 months. So, you know, get on board. So we asking anybody in Columbus, Cleveland, Cincinnati, or anybody that you know in this area, man, come out Saturday at 3 o'clock at the King Arts Complex, man. This is about our babies. This ain't about us. This ain't about, you know what I'm saying, what we need to do. It's about what we need to do for our children. And Marcus is going to be here with his son to help us launch this school, because that's revolutionary when we take our children's education into our own hands and stop killing them, sending them to the killing fields every day, which is these public schools.
That's the truth of the matter. All right, y'all heard it. All right, support Brother Insights, my man Morgan. Support Brother Marcus Klein and his school, and listen to what he just finished saying. They're getting ready to revolutionize the minds of the masses, the children. You know, they're getting ready to open up a school. You know, what else could be more phenomenal than that? Is to take the curriculum back into our hands, the history, the truth, our legacy, our heritage, back into our hands. Not to be told that we are just slaves in two pages in a science, social science book, nor in a history book. You know, or to be told that only leader that we had was Martin Luther the King. You know, so these are the things in which that we have to realize. You know, no doubt. All right, thanks, Brother Insight. Appreciate you, God.
All right, thank you, family. I'll holler at you and the Queen, man. Y'all be blessed and have a good show, man.
All right, thanks. Peace.
All right, peace and blessings.
All right, we have caller 313. You're on the line. You're on the air. Caller 313. Peace.
Peace and love, bro.
Peace and love.
Peace and love.
Your phone breaking up a little bit.
Hey, can you hear me?
Yeah, now we can, yes.
Peace and love. What's going on, Brother Alim? This is Tamir from Detroit.
Greetings. Peace, God. How you doing?
I'm good. How's Kadir?
Oh, we're doing good.
I didn't catch the whole show, but I did want to make a comment concerning the brothers and sisters that's in that life and in that particular industry. You know, the role model thing of how the youth is looking up to them because they think they got this high financial status, that's just not true. You know, for all the money that Jay-Z or Diddy or any of them have made, the people who control them, if they want them missing or that wealth or that fame or that money missing tomorrow, it can happen. Period.
Right.
Period. And people need to wake up and realize that.
Oof. No doubt.
Yeah,
no
that's
doubt.
That's all. That's really all I wanted to say, because I know that's predominantly the reason that, you know, the people in my area in Detroit look up to these little rappers, hip hop artists, whatever you want to call them, is because they think they financially set. And that's a fantasy. That's a bull.
Well, that definitely is the case, you know, and if people don't say that rappers have influence, then you might want to ask yourself why your child got his pants hanging off his ass if the rappers don't have influence, because that's a fad that's been around now for at least 20 years. You know, just because they got the skinny jeans on and they still sagging don't mean anything. The sagging thing came from out of the prison system, in which that's symbolic to easy access, and the rappers started doing that back in the mid-90s with the sagging, you know, and the pants hanging off the ass. So, you know, if it's not the influence, then look around you and see how influential rap music is, hip-hop is, you know. You know, and we just have to ask ourselves, Is it being ushered in negatively or is it being ushered in positively? You know, we'll let y'all determine that. So we won't get into all of that, you know, but you've been listening to the show, then you know what we've been dropping on. And if you can debut it, you know, then please feel free in order to get online and cause some controversy. All right, thanks, Sister Tamara. Appreciate you, goddess.
Peace.
All right, we got caller 718. You're on the line. Caller 718, you're on the line.
Peace, God. Bless up, Brother Alim El-Bey.
Yes, it
Much
is.
Much respect. This is Rudra LSD Shiva. I'm calling
Green
from Brooklyn, Flatbush. And I'm a music artist as well. And I'm also putting out a lot of positive stuff to keep, you know, influencing and uplifting the youths around me, because I'm in the area where they got Blood, Crip, Latin King, a whole bunch of stuff. And I come from that area, and I'm dealing with a lot of science. And the thing is, the science that they deal with has to deal with the realness, and they might not know about it. But with this whole hip-hop thing, I mean, they really got us in a headlock, because ever since P. Diddy got his reality show, and I know it's been going on before him, but ever since he got his reality show, now it's like, when artists are going to get signed, the record labels don't even have to sit there and try to persuade you to be a pimp or a hoe or a gangster or a fake gangster in the video, because P. Diddy's show is already showing you, look, you got to be a hoe, or the making a band show, you know, or you got to learn how to dance and all of this stuff. So now they're taking out the soul out of hip-hop. In my days, I'm 32. And in my days, I just remember it was a time that you could actually spit some nice poetic lyrics, and you might be able to get signed or played. But nowadays, you got to do all of this break dance. And I keep telling people that the way that they got the world in a headlock, hip-hop is going to be like Justin Bieber in the next 3 years. It's changing. It's really going to be Justin Bieber in the next 3 to 5 years. And my cousin is DJ Clue, and I have nothing bad to say about him, but he doesn't look out for me. And, you know, me and him talk about things like this all day, and he knows it's coming. And the way I see it is, I'm like, why don't you put out some information? You know, why don't you tell one of your artists to put something valuable out there? Because, you know, I mean, it's in a headlock. I'm in Brooklyn. People are worshiping Jay-Z, and Jay-Z hasn't done nothing for Brooklyn. He goes to Marcy Projects with Oprah, but he's across the street. He's not inside Marcy Projects. You know what I mean? Like, I live in Ebbetsfield housing, and there's plenty of artists that mention that name and still don't come over here and love.
Right.
You know, and it's one question before I go, how do you feel, or what are your thoughts on as far as who do we trust and who do we not trust as far as in the hip hop game? Because I know not everybody that throws up certain signs are Illuminati, but I know that certain people that do throw up signs are puppets. You know, because I don't want to say that, you know, I don't want to put, because I know Immortal Technique is the truth. Sons of Man, Hellraiser, they're the truth. But then sometimes we might look at a Lupe Fiasco, you know, and then just certain things, because the way I see TV, they really have it on lock, like COINTELPRO technology, because we could watch the news and we'll see Roseanne Barr and I forgot the other guy's name, but Roseanne Barr and some other white dude arguing on the news show. But basically, what they're saying certain things to make us agree, certain things that are real, but the solution, they always point us back to a certain place. I listen to Al Sharpton on the radio talking about, like, the music is messing up the youth's minds. They got us killing each other and selling drugs and all this other stuff, but then he refers us back to the church. It is not, you understand what I'm saying? So I understand the technology in that. So how do you feel about the whole, like, who do we trust, who we shouldn't trust, and feel that the Prodigy letter about Jay-Z kind of helping to trying to help Jacob York and the COINTELPRO take down the master teacher, Dr. York. Do you feel that letter is truthful? And if it's not, because if it's truthful, that means that the people should already know, like, we shouldn't trust Jay-Z. Because
well,
people,
I mean,
in my time, have forgot that. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and then according to Prodigy, that letter was real. He wrote that.
Okay.
According to him. And this is why he did this song. You know, I don't know if you ever heard it. It's called Black Devils.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I got
right,
it.
Well,
yeah.
Right, well, that's the reason why he did that song. You know, is because of some of the things in which that was happening in the industry. So you say, who can you trust? The only one that I can know of right now that I've had contact with is probably African Man Bada, because he actually is a student of Dr. York.
Yes.
You know, as far as in hip-hop, you know what I'm saying? And but if you notice, he threw up the sign, which they call Baphomet, but he got that sign from George Clinton, who throws that sign up, you know, when he was with the Funkadelics in Parliament, you know.
Yeah.
But what did that sign really mean? Because, I mean, that actually is also symbolic to the head of Anubis, or Ampu.
Yeah.
You know, so, I mean, what one might say is Baphomet, that actually is Ampu. But Ampu is being seen as the angel of death. Because in the scene of the soul scene, or what is called the but it's also called the resurrection scene, is also been referred to as the judgment scene. But in the judgment scene, for lack of a better term, you will see Ampu near the scales of balance of Mayat. You know,
yeah.
Which that was symbolic to him ushering in Ani, which is the soul before Osaw. You know,
yep.
So I mean, all of these symbolisms is ancient Egyptian. Once again, you can't go nowhere outside of the symbolism of the ancient Egyptians. Freemasonry is based on ancient Egyptian. Period. So anything that the European does, if you go back and look at it in ancient Egypt, you have the accurate perception, regardless of what they state that it is, regardless of what they claim that it is, because we know that their Freemasonry goes back to Egypt. You know, so it's just about who else can you trust? Like you said, members of the Wu, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Who's really into the information, really into the knowledge, you know. Like you said, the Sons of Man, Keller Army, you know, cats who are conscious, Immortal Technique. I mean, who's been spitting up for consciousness, you know, the laws of the Lost Children of Babylon.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, a lot of people, you know what I'm saying, who's been spitting real stuff for years. No radio play. Just straight underground, you know. And they've been doing it and still doing it and got tours from doing it, you know what I'm saying, and they're touring. You know, they're doing all types of things, but yet they're still underground. You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
I mean, shoot, look at J. Electronica. You know, he signed, you know what I'm saying, you know, with Jay-Z, you know what I'm saying?
Yep.
I mean, look at him. He's still underground, really.
Yep.
You know, so, I mean,
Do you think they're using him?
It's possible. Who knows? You know what I'm saying? I can't get into what's going on. I can just look at what has happened. Now, what's going on, in a sense, can always be perception or can be perceptionalized. You know, it can be conceptualized. You know, we can come up with a perception or a concept, you know, and say, okay, well, this what this is, you know. But, you know, will he allow for himself to be? That's the question.
That's true.
You know, based on the information that he's been dropping, that would be a no.
Mm.
You know, but once again, it goes to who we refer to as sellouts. You don't really sell your soul in the sense of what they are talking about, but you do sell your integrity, your pride, your honesty, in order to have fame and fortune, and hence become a channel for the muse or for those beings in which they're supposed to give you the concepts for the music. And I know that one sister told me, who was in Hollywood, she had to get out of Hollywood because there were so many spirits coming to her, talking to her, trying to get her to make the oath. You know, for example, if you say, I do anything, if this is the mind state that you have, if you say, I would do anything to get in the industry,
But guess what's going to happen? Those beings are going to come to you in order to usher you into a particular position in order to be able to get to where you want to be at. And in the process,
that's
you have
true.
To make blood sacrifices for them to do so.
Yep.
You have to make some type of sacrifice, whether it's of yourself or someone else. Okay?
That's true.
And of yourself, once again, this is where we get these rappers going to jail for a day and for a year and a day. Where that came from? Little Kim went to jail for, supposedly was going to go to jail for a year and a day. T.I. was going to go to jail for a year and a day.
Lil Wayne.
Yeah, for a year and a day. What the hell is this? What is that? One
and
one.
And you know what?
That's that 9/11 shit over again. That's that same type of thing being done over again. You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
And so that's their sacrifice, was having to go to jail. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, they had to take a portion of their life and the work, or be able to do whatever they had to do inside of that system. You know what I'm saying? So they might not have
right.
to necessarily do a blood sacrifice because they already did a sacrifice in themselves. And here T.I. is getting ready to get another 10 months in jail because of the recent thing with him and his wife in Atlanta, Georgia.
Mm.
Having ecstasy and weed in the car. So that was his violation, probation. He violated his probation. So he ended up getting another 10 months. You know, so these
that's
are all
crazy.
The things that's going on. So we just have to be aware, you know what I'm saying?
Yep.
Symbolic. You know, we have to know symbolism.
I agree.
Yeah, so we just have to know, you know, all of these things, you know. But I appreciate you, Ak, for calling in. Let's finish this up, just the last segment before we end the show. I'm glad for those that are sticking and hanging on. You know, y'all getting the real information. You ain't going to get this nowhere else. I already know that. So this is the key. So you are the Naga people. You are the Serpentine Fire people, the masters of this energy at the base chakra, who can raise that energy up without too much of a problem. Because you have activated pineal glands. For those that have calcified pineal glands or who is called third eye blind, then they run the risk of raising the kundalini. And if it strikes the kundalini Shiva, what happens is they can spontaneous human combust. So if they can, that is what's going on. So this is the reason why the ancients, who was the Kundalini yoga masters and so forth, always warn the people about raising the Kundalini energy. They weren't per se speaking about the Nagas, who's the masters of it. They was talking about more so the individuals who did not have or possessed as much melanin content or who ran the risk of having calcification in the pineal gland. According to African Biological Psychiatry by Dr. Richard King, 5 to 15% of African people have pineal gland calcification, 20 to 35 Asians, and 60 to 80% Europeans. So being that they had the highest calcification, it was really talking about them being warned about not raising the Kundalini energy up because of that possibility. However, there are particular sounds to help those who have pineal calcifications. One of the sounds is THOH sound, T-H-O-H. That's one of the sounds. You'll feel lightheaded. You'll feel dizzy. You'll feel probably have headaches, migraines possibly, depending on how much the degree of calcification is, but those are some of the symptoms. All right? Being that you've been, the people have been eating this type of diet, you just finished hearing it in, from Pharoahe Monch, when he just finished saying that, you know, his mom couldn't afford whole foods, you know, to eat organic. So she called her food soul food, you know, when she prayed over it. You know, so that's what's going on in our community still to this day. So it's real simple. You know, based on the, you know, foods, 98% of the food in the supermarkets are genetically altered. So that means if they are genetically altered, that means that they are gene-altering organisms that is tampering with your DNA, your light codes. And more than likely, they're locking it down so that you will not get the transmissions from your ancestral communications from your ancestors who are within you as well as also outside of you on the ionosphere, in the ionosphere, which is about 62 miles to 3,000 miles up into the sky, hence what is called heaven. Get the Unk book, and this goes into depths about it. And this is what is going on.
First of all the radio, finally, we are on the air. No doubt.
All right. There's always going to be somebody in the building on First World Order Radio.
We get on into some of that order consciousness tonight.
First World Order Radio every Wednesday, 8 p.m.
We got to talk about what is taking place on the planet.
There's always going to be somebody in the building on First World Order Radio. First, we need to let you know we're going to be doing more shows, giving out more information on Wednesdays. Wednesday at 8 o'clock, we are now going to make this is the hottest day of the week.
Seen in others in time, order, importance. The most prominent parts, voices, or instruments. Earthly state of human concerns in existence. An indefinite multitude, quantity, or distance. System regulates to bring about specifics in the group based on value and natural characteristics. Current radiates electromagnetistics of sound through the air, same as your thoughts transmits it. Proceeding in others in time, order, importance. The most prominent parts, voices, or instruments. Earthly state of human concerns in existence. An indefinite multitude, quantity, or distance. System regulates to bring about specifics in the group based on value and natural characteristics. Current radiates electromagnetistics of sound through the air, same as your thoughts transmits it.
You need to understand how magical this, something like this every Wednesday can become. So you need to start getting your calendar right, get your schedule right. You need to know our intention straight out.
All right, so, I mean, these clues are given throughout the various languages was to piece the puzzle of this ancient mystery school back together again.
And what we plan on doing, both of us, is bringing y'all some surefire dynamite. We're going to take this level up a notch. We're going to have stuff to do here. This is not just going to be about philosophies and theories, shit that works.